This is the Emmanuel Family Devotion for Tuesday, August the 17th. The text for this devotion is our hymn from this past Sunday, Come, Ye Thankful People, Come, number 892. The author of this hymn was an odd bird, to say the least. He was a clergyman in the Church of England in the middle of the 1800s. Reportedly, he dressed in bright and clashing clothes. When about town, he traveled with his pig and kept a horse in his home. It is said he relaxed with opium. He was devoted to the poor and even gathered dead sailors off the beach after shipwrecks to give them proper burial. He also wrote this hymn, all about the harvest, the time when we realize God's blessing upon our land and our efforts to make it productive. The language of the farmer fills the hymn with phrases like harvest home, wheat and tares, blade, ear, full corn, and garner, granary. All of the hymn is a recognition that it is our Lord who provides us with such blessings. Our Maker doth provide, for our wants to be supplied. Reflects Psalm 34, those who seek the Lord lack no good thing. And Jesus in Matthew 6, look at the birds of the air, they neither sow nor reap nor gather into barns, and yet your heavenly Father feeds them. He does the same still today. The last two verses speak of another harvest, the harvest that will come at the end of time. For our Lord, our God, shall come and take his harvest home. From his field shall in that day all offenses purge away. You and I will be on the harvest side of that final day because all our offenses have been purged away. Jesus did that work for us on his cross. All our sins have been removed, and we will join the Lord in glory. Harvests now are a great blessing to us. The harvest then will bring an eternal blessing and joy. Our closing prayer is verse 4. Even so, Lord, quickly come to thy final harvest home. Gather thou thy people in, free from sorrow, free from sin. There forever purified, in thy garner to abide. Come with all thine angels, come, raise the glorious harvest home. In Jesus' name, amen. We'll see you tomorrow.